Hi guys! Today I am going to be going through everything that I loved in the month of September. And if I look like I have flowers coming out of my head, I don't. It's just a lovely vase behind me. But yeah, it kind of makes it look like they're coming out of my head. Anyway, so yes, there was a lot of like non-beauty related favourites this month. And so I've just incorporated them in as well because it's a monthly favourite, so it doesn't have to be just makeup and beauty products. So I've got a few other things that I'm going to be sharing as well. But let's start with the beauty products. And for some reason I've not really been wearing like lipstick this month. Like today is like one of the first days I've actually put it on. But I've been going for like a very simple eye, so I've just not been wearing much makeup really. So I've been using very neutral eye shadows and a great base, but even for if you're any base, if you're going to be using bright eyeshadow or just a really neutral colour, it's always good to put on a nice base. And the one in my Naked palette is the one I've been using loads this month. I never touched it before when I first bought this, and when I did buy it, the lady said to me, "Oh, that's a great base colour." And I was like, why do you want a base colour? You can't see it. But it just allows your eyeshadow to set better. And it's just giving you that all over colour on your eyelid. Because some people get like veiny eyelids or red eyelids, or if you get oily eyelids, it's just good to put a base on and you're starting on a clean palette as such. So yes, the colour in my Naked palette that I've been using to do that is called Foxy. And it's just a very neutral tone. That's my Naked palette there. And yeah, it's just a very neutral, just no colour, just a skin colour, because that's what you're wanting. You're just wanting a nice base for your eyeshadow. So yeah, that one is called Foxy in the Naked palette 2. But you can get that anywhere. Like, it's just a nice kind of skin colour. Hopefully I explained that okay for you. So yeah, that's what I've been using this month. Before I put on any kind of eye makeup, I've just been loving putting on a base beforehand. Now, I have another eye product as well. Now this one, I wouldn't apply the powder base before I put this on. I would just go straight on with it, and it's nice and neutral. This is more, this is like a base for cream eyeshadows. So that's like your base for powder eyeshadows. And this one I use if I'm going to be using like either shadow sticks or like a pot. Or I just use it on its own. I really, really, really love this. I did used to use a Clinique one. Before I got into makeup, I would always just have, like, I wore it every single day. And I was so not adventurous. It was just a nice kind of neutral shimmer, and that's all I ever did with my eyes. But then it ran out, so I bought another one, and I got a Smashbox one. And it looks like this. I love Smashbox packaging. It's just really like nice and simple. And so anyway, it is the Limitless 15 Hour Wear Cream Shadow, and it is in topaz. Now I don't know if it lasts 15 hours. That's actually the first time I've read that, because I don't really ever like have my face on for 15 hours, really. You would not have got much sleep that day if it was the case. But basically, I might have it on for like 10 hours, but it lasts like the full 10 hours. I don't have overly oily eyes or oily eyelids, so I don't know if I'm a great judge on that one. But yeah, it lasts really long on me, and it's just such a nice colour. I've got it on just now, and it just gives me a slight sheen. Nothing major. I do it if I want a really simple eye and I want a bold lip like I've got on today. That's what I'll wear. And it is perfect. I really, really, really love this product. And I really love Smashbox. Moving on to my last makeup product, my last monthly favourite of the makeup. It is the Maybelline Mega Plush Volume Express Mascara. Now I bought this like ages ago, and I bought it because I love the packaging. Look at the colours, it's so nice, it's like purpley pink and turquoise. And yeah, that's why I bought it. And I know Maybelline are always known for doing really good mascaras, so I thought, can't go wrong here. So I bought it, and it's also like Maybelline's first, like, I'll show you if I can, it kind of like, can you see that? It like, it goes, it kind of, you know, it's like bendy. So yeah, it's got like a bendy wand. And it's a really thick wand though, as well, if you can see that. And yeah, it's just great for applying mascara, but it's really simple. So I always, whenever I like wear my Smashbox Simple Eye, I wear this, and I've got it on today. And it's just a really simple eyelash, no clumping, very kind of subtle. It's not like a wow eyes. It's just very simple. It doesn't clump at all. It goes on well. It separates your eyelashes. It makes them dark because I have really light eyelashes. And yeah, it's just really simple and I like it. I just wear it whenever I want simple eyes. And as I say, this month I've been going for the whole simple eye look. So yes, I've been loving that. Now moving on to skincare. I only have one skincare product favourite this month, because I've been using just like the same products as last month. It is the L'Oreal Skin Perfection 3-in-1 Purifying, I can never say this word, Micellar Solution. It looks like that. And I finished my Bioderma, and you know how much I love my Bioderma. And it's like a bit of an annoying product to buy because you can only buy it online, you can't buy it in stores. So whenever I'm like out of it, I'm just like, oh, for God's sake, I've got to go online and order more. And it's just annoying because then you've got to wait for it to come. So I saw this in Boots, and it was on sale actually as well. And it was like £3 or something, so really cheap. And I was like, I'll give it a go, see if it's as good as my Bioderma. And it is exactly the same. Exactly the same. Like, there is no difference. I wouldn't say that I love it more, and I wouldn't say I love it less than Bioderma, but I love Bioderma, so I love this. It's really good. It's slightly cheaper than Bioderma as well, because, well, the site I buy it from, you get a discount anyway, so it's like, I don't know, it's like say a fiver for the same amount, or £5 or £6 for the same amount, and this is only £3, so it is about half the price. And I'd say it's pretty much the same. I'm actually struggling to remember my Bioderma because it was so long ago that I used it, so I will repurchase my Bioderma to remember its greatness. But I would definitely repurchase this as well. It's really, really good. I've been loving using this. It takes all my makeup off. When I say it takes all my makeup off, it's like the first step that I do, so I don't really want it to take all my makeup off anyway. Well, not that I don't want it to, but it doesn't need to, because I then wash my face and I then use my clarifying lotion, blah de blah de blah. So I have a few steps in taking my makeup off, but this is the first one, and it is a relatively deep clean. So yeah, and it's really easy. Just get a cotton wool pad, da 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 da, and you're done. I love it. Okay, so moving on to, this is a kind of weird product. It's to do with your mouth, so it's not exactly skincare or hair care, or makeup. It's mouth care, and this is a little random, and I think it's leaking as well. But it's the Colgate Plax Antibacterial Mouthwash in Soft Mint, 12-hour protection. And yes, I really like this. It's like, because you're thinking, why are you showing a mouthwash in your monthly favourites? Well, because it has been a monthly favourite. I get really, really, really pernickety about my mouthwash. My mum like buys, you can't even remember what it's called. It's so disgusting though. It's like one where you've got to shake, because, and if you don't shake it, you basically get a mouth of what tastes like oil, like petrol oil. I can't even describe it, but even when you shake it, it still tastes like that. And it leaves like this horrible, oily, greasy flavour in your mouth. It's just so disgusting. So I was like, I am not using that. And she's bought like loads of it. So I'm like, oh my God, I need to get my own. And this was on sale, and I just love it. It's soft mint, so it's not like something that's going to tear your mouth apart, because I find that with Listerine that it like hurts your mouth because it's so strong mint. This is just soft mint, and it's really good. I can keep it in my mouth as long as I want to. It doesn't hurt, and it leaves me nice and fresh. And yeah, I think it's protecting my teeth. Hopefully it is. So yeah, I've been loving that. Now, moving on to hair care, and I've just got one product. And because I've been having such drama with my hair lately, I've not been wanting to use straighteners or heat on my hair, so I've been trying to let it just dry naturally and go a little bit curly, because my hair is quite curly when it, you know, when you just leave it to dry, when I don't blow dry it. So I've been using the bamboo style boho waves, and it's a tousled, I think that's how you say the word, texture mist. Now I got this in a glossy box a couple months ago. Really need to resubscribe to glossy box, I miss it a lot. But yes, so I just started using this. I found it and I was like, oh, I'll use that because I'm trying to keep my hair in good condition and just go all natural. And it says it has organic bamboo and blue yucca root for sustainable style. And what I like about this is that it's not like the Bumble and Bumble salt spray. That's very drying on my hair. I mean, I would maybe use it, you know, if I came out the sea and I needed something to like style my hair that's going to keep it styled, because it does keep it styled, but it is very drying on my hair, so I wouldn't really use it day to day. So I needed one that was very kind of just natural. You didn't see the product in your hair. So yes, this has just been perfect for doing that. And this is the wee tester size, but I probably would buy that full size. Okay, so that's all my products done. I will move on to my fashion one. I just have one fashion one, and it's something that I've been wearing all month to my work, because at work I have to dress kind of, you know, formally. And I've just been loving it. It just totally, even if you, you know, even if you're going casual but you want something just to quickly make you look a bit more formal, throw on this jacket and you will be looking very sharp indeed. And it is from Zara, even though I have it on a Topshop hanger, it is from Zara. And it's quite hard to show you, but that is it. It is a blazer. It's kind of like dark grey cotton in this section, and then it has leather sleeves. Yeah, it's just got the one button, two little pockets with the collar. And yeah, it is just really, really smart. Instantly formalizes outfit, but especially like with a white shirt underneath, it just looks so sharp. And yeah, I love it. At the back it's just it's quite tailored. It's got the wee slit there, if you can see, but yeah, it pulls you in at the waist. And it also, because of the leather sleeves, it is quite a structured shoulder, and it's got a little bit of shoulder padding in it as well. So yeah, it's really, really smart, and I've been wearing this almost every day to my work. I've been loving it. Okay, so that's my fashion one. Moving on, and I will be doing my book one. Now, I don't really read that much, but a friend gave me this and I have been absolutely loving it. Well, I finished it, so I loved it. And I finished it really quickly, so it shows you just how much I did love it. And it is The Vogue Factor, The Inside Story of Fashion's Most Illustrious Magazine by Kirsty Clements. Now, Kirsty Clements was the editor-in-chief of Australian Vogue. And basically, at the end of her career, I think she was like the editor for, like, it was over 10 years anyway. And she started off in Vogue as like a receptionist. And she built her way up. I'm not sure if it was a receptionist, but it was some, you know, it was not a very, you know, high up role in Vogue, but she started at the bottom, as Drake would say, and she made her way up to be editor. But basically at the end of her career she got let go, you know, kind of fired, but for no really good reason, as it would seem. But basically that's not really what the book's about, because she just mentions that at the end, but it's just about her journey through Vogue and her insight of the fashion world. And it's really, really interesting. If you want to get into the fashion industry, it really shows an insight. Even if you don't want to work in a fashion magazine, it kind of shows you how Fashion Week works, how designers work, and how, you know, the politics within fashion, agents, celebrities, how, you know, you really have to work people to get what you want. And but not in a bad way, but, you know, just in a business sense. And yeah, it's a really, really good insight into the fashion world, and into her as well. She seems like a lovely person. And yeah, it's a really, really good book. I have a kind of other random favourite. this is an app on my phone. Where's my phone? It sounds kind of nerdy, I don't know why, but it's the BBC iPlayer. Because I'm at uni now, I'm back to uni, and I do marketing, so my lecturer told me there's this great shopping program, like how shopping has evolved from like the start of the 20th century through to like the 21st century, you know, how it's changed and how it's like now online and, you know, blah de blah de blah. I'm not going to bore you with marketing, but so I had to watch it and I was like, oh, I don't have time, I have so much to do. But I was like, I'll download it and then watch it on the bus. So I was like, because obviously you don't need Wi-Fi when you download a program. So I got the app, and that's what I've been doing on my way to work and on my way back to work. I've just been watching the programs that I've downloaded to the iPlayer app, and that's it there. So you have your downloads, and they download really quickly, you know, obviously you need Wi-Fi, so I just do that at home. I download all the ones I want to watch, and then I watch them on the way to work and on the way back. And yeah, so it's the shopping one I've been watching, and Dragon's Den. I like downloaded the whole series of Dragon's Den, and I've been watching all the episodes because I love Dragon's Den. It's like, it's just so funny, like, oh my god, they're so scary. I would never have the nerve to go on that program. But anyway, so that's, I've been really loving using that app and kind of like discovered it. I always knew it was there, but I didn't realise, oh, you can download programs and then watch them without the need for Wi-Fi and all that. So yes, I've been loving that. Now I have two song favourites this month, like I did last month. And they are Roar by Katy Perry. Oh my god, that song is so like, I'm not a fan of Katy Perry. I think she's quite like, you know, cheesy and, you know, like just a bit cheesy, yeah, and a bit like not me basically, a bit too goody two shoes, I don't know. Like, yeah, but anyway, I've been loving this song. It's kind of like her comeback song, not a comeback song, but like, you know, a new song of her album. She's been away for a while. So I was like, I'm gonna listen to that and I love it. It's so empowering. It's like, you're gonna hear me roar. I don't know, it's just like, that was a really, really bad interpretation of that song. But I've been really loving it. It's very motivational, good tune. Yeah, it's nice and cheesy, but in a good way, a really good way. I really like it. Now my second song is bloody fantastic. Oh my god, I'm so excited about this song because, well, yeah, it does have Rihanna in it. But so that is like a major factor of why I'm loving it. But it's ASAP Rocky, and it's not actually featuring Rihanna singing, it's just she's in the video. But yeah, it's ASAP Rocky, Fashion Killer. And it is so damn good. He mentions basically every fashion designer you can think of in the song. Like literally, he just rolls off the names. And yeah, the video is amazing. You definitely have to check out the video. I will link it below. It's got Rihanna in it, but it's a really cool take on like on music videos. It's not like what you'd expect. It's very laid back. It's very like, I don't know. It's just, it's really, really good. They're not like, because she's not in the song, like she doesn't sing in the song, so she's obviously not singing, and neither is he. They're just kind of like sailing through the video, like chatting, shopping in a really cool way, because it's like at night as well, and it's just really different. And she looks stunning, he looks quite good as well. They would make such a good couple. But so yeah, and the song is just so good as well. I love how it mentions all the cool designers, and he obviously knows his stuff. And it's a really good tune. And the video just came out yesterday, so I don't know like how many people have seen it or who's heard the song, but it is so good. I will link the video below, and yes. But so anyway, that is all my favourites for this month. There was, yeah, like quite a selection, different kinds, because not every month I'm using like new products or makeup or whatever. So yes, I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel below. Check out my blog, Glad Drags and Name Tags, and you can follow me on Twitter. I have a Facebook page, Instagram, all that stuff. I will link it all below. And yet, also tell me, leave a comment below of what your favourite products have been in September and what you've been loving. Any new songs, products, anything like that, let me know. Okay, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!